Hello friends, in this session we will discuss how to solve compound interest questions without using pen by using digital sum method, right? You know about digital sum method. What is digital sum method? In digital sum method, we do the sum of digits of the number until we get a single digit. For example, if the number is 253, the digital sum will be the sum of digits, which is 2 plus 5 plus 3. So 2 plus 5 is 7 plus 3 is 10. Now 1 plus 0, 10 means what? 1, right? So we do the sum of digits until we get a single digit. And in case of digital sum method, 9 is always equivalent to 0. So wherever we are getting 9, we should consider this equal to 0. So let's say if I take a number 981726. So if I want to find out the digital sum of this number, so wherever I am seeing 9, I have to consider this as 0. So 9 will become 0. Now 8 plus 1, 9 will become 0. Now 7 plus 2, 9 will become 0. So the only digit which is left is 6. So the digital sum of this particular number is 6. So we have this question. Principal is rupees 15,000. R is 18% per annum, compounded annually. This is the rate of interest. Time is 2 years and you have to find out the amount, right? Now, these are the four options in front of you. You know the formula to find out the amount in case of compound interest. The amount is always equal to principal 1 plus R by 100 raised to the power number of years, right? So what is the principal here? Principal is 15,000. 1 plus rate is 18% by 100 and the time period is 2 years. So it will become 15,000 into 118 by 100 square. Right? Now, after this, you do not need to solve, right? You have to just find out the digital sum of this number and match that particular digital sum with the digital sum of the given options, right? So, what is the digital sum of this particular number? 1 plus 5 is what? 6. So, the digital sum is 6 multiplied with 1 plus 8. 1 plus 8 will become 9 and 9 is equivalent to 0. Now, 0 plus 1 is 1 and 1 and 1 plus 0 plus 0 is 1, right? So 1 upon 1 is 1 and 1 square is what? 1. So 1 into 6 will become 6. So I can say the digital sum of this particular number is 6. Now let's check the digital sum of the options. So if I check the digital sum of this number, so 8 plus 8, 16. 16 plus 2 is 18 and 18 is a multiple of 9. 8 plus 1 is also 9, so 9 will become 0. So 8, 16 plus 2 is 18 and any multiple of 9 will become 0. So it will become 6. Only 6 is left. Now if I talk about the digital sum of this particular number, 9 will become 0. Now 8 plus 2, 10. 10 means 1 plus 0, which is 1. And 1 plus 6 will become 7, right? Now what about this? This is 9, that will become 0. Now 8 plus 2, 10. 10 means 1. And 1 plus 6 is 7. And here it is 9, 9, 0. And this is 2 plus 6 is 8. So the only option which matches the digital sum of this particular number is the first option, which is 6. So the answer is option 1. Now let's take one more example. Principal is 200, rate is 10% per annum, time is 2 years, and you have to find out the amount. So we have to solve this question without picking pen. So how can we solve? First of all, we have to consider the amount. Amount will be principal, which is 200. 1 plus R by 100, that means 1 plus 10 by 100, that is 110. By 100 raised to the power n, where n is 2 years, right? So what is the digital sum of this number? This is 2 multiplied with 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 plus 0 is 2, so 2 square. So 2 into 2 square is 8, right? So we can say the digital sum of this particular number is 8. So now let's look at the options. The digital sum of the first option will be 2 plus 2, 4 plus 3 is 7. Here 2 plus 4 plus 2 is 8, here 9, here 4 plus 4 8, 8 plus 2 is 10, 10 means 1. So the only option which matches with the digital sum of this amount is the second option, which is the required answer. So friends, this is how you can apply the concept of digital sum in the questions of compound interest and solve the questions without using pen.